You look at the facilities, the people at the club, the players, the fans, the stadium, everything. It's a Premier League club and I think that's where everyone wants to see Swansea, and there's no point setting low goals. You should aim to be the absolute best.
Nathan, welcome to Swansea City. Great to have you here as our first summer signing. I'd imagine you're really excited and looking forward to get down to work now that everything's done and dusted.
Yeah, of course. Buzzing to be here, obviously. I think it's like a week till pre-season and like, I just want to get going. I always feel like I'm a bit restless in the off-season anyway. Like, just want to get down to business and play football.
Yeah, and I know you've spoken to Russell Martin at quite some length through this process and in terms of deciding about your future. You know, how were those conversations? And I'm guessing he must have made a very positive impression on you.
Yeah, well, me and Russell have spoke a couple of times over the years, but like when he was at MK Dons, and we've always like kind of kept in touch and had like a decent relationship. And as soon as I knew that like it was an option to come here, like I didn't really want to go anywhere else because like I know a lot about the club, like the style of player, the manager, like they've obviously got some really good players. And like, yeah, it's a bit of a no-brainer to be honest. But yeah, the manager obviously did play a big part in it.
You mentioned the style of play there, Nathan. You know, Swansea obviously have a quite a unique way of playing, but that's obviously been an attractive part of coming here for you. You know, what do you make of how Swansea play and how well do you think you'll fit into it?
Yeah, obviously like, it's not just like with the current manager, it's been like throughout the years, and it's always been like a club that I looked at and thought it'd be nice to play for them, the style of play, like I think football's the right way, like the way they're playing, like, I feel like I'd fit in well. I like to play football like the way like the manager likes to play, the way the club likes to play, and I feel like it's a good fit for me, so.
Yeah, it sounds like you've admired the Swans from afar, I feel like, yeah. Then over the years.
Yeah, well.
Any players stand out from your time watching them as you've grown?
I remember the big ones like Wilfred Bolly.
Yeah.
Like loads of different ones, but like as a player you always have in mind clubs that you might want to go to, and like Swansea's always been one of them clubs I've looked at with the style of play and fit, like seems like a good fit for me, so.
Yeah, and you're known as a player who's comfortable on the ball, good at the ball at his feet, but also, you know, powerful physically, very athletic. But then how would you sum yourself up as a player?
How would I describe myself? I do enjoy the physical and mental battle of defending, like that's my job at the end of the day, but the most an enjoyable part of it is playing with the ball, and obviously it's a big part of this club and the manager and the way Swansea play, so I feel like fitting well with the defending side of it and the footballing side of it.
Yeah, I mean, football, you've obviously always been a talented footballer, but you were a very accomplished schoolboy athlete as well, Nathan. Is it right you were in the top 10 in your age bracket in the UK for high jump at one point?
I think when I actually had like a bit of a buzz for it at one point. I didn't go into an academy until I was 13, so I got the chance to like do athletics, like play rugby in school. I was very good at it, but played football, athletics. And at one point, athletics was like probably one of my main focuses, like because when the football season finishes in the summer, you have your athletics. And I admired like Usain Bolt. I used to do like everything, long jump, high jump, sprints, middle distance. And yeah, I think like I was good at some things, but like it always comes back to football, like one of them things. But like I feel like that's a big part of like me as a player today, like that like the upbringing I had with athletics, and I've got to thank my coaches and that, from Glenn and Carol, they're still doing the exact same thing they've been doing for years, like coaching people. Like I'll never forget like what they've done for me, and I feel like that helps me today massively.
Yeah, sort of being exposed to different sports, different. Yeah. You know, if you really think that's been a big.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and you might not want us to bring this up, so apologies in advance.
I know what
but,
it is.
But I'm sure a few Swans fans have probably already found the CBBC sort of little docu-series of school which you were in, successfully getting into the school football team.
Yeah.
How did that come about? Did you enjoy it? And how much stick have you had over the years for it?
It came about like BBC came into my primary school and wanted to like film the transition of kids in the second from primary school to secondary school, and like I got picked because like I was a bit of like an outgoing kid, like very energetic, obviously, like loved my sports, and it was okay. Like it was different, and I feel like it helped me, you know, be out my comfort zone with interviews and things like that. As I got older, I got a bit more distance to it. Like obviously, like when you're in school, you have like your mates and that. Like I just wanted to be, like at one point, I just wanted to be like, just normal like everyone else. I didn't really want the cameras following me that much. Like, but then and as I got older, it stopped. And but it is nice places I go. Like I meet like young kids that have seen it, and it is nice. Like now I'm totally glad I done it because I can look back on it and be like, oh, when I was seven, like, all I wanted to do was be a footballer, and like now, like I'm on the right path. Yeah. So, good.
We're going to ask you, do you know what happened to Alex, the kid who was in it, who didn't
get
in the
football team? Alex, like, it's funny you mention him because, like, I've bumped into him quite a lot in the past couple of months, just out and about. I seen him at, like, the cinemas, the place in Middlesbrough, like, I seen him around there, like, he's good, like, still, like, similar, like, me, like, similar personality, and it's always nice to bump into people you went to school with, and he's happy, like, to see me playing football and doing what I love, so it's nice, yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, you got the chance to join Middlesbrough's academy.
Yeah.
Can you just sort of talk us through how that came about, like, how you were spotted, if you like?
So, I got scouted playing for my district, I think, just with my mates, like, obviously, as a kid, you always want to be in an academy, and growing up in Middlesbrough, that was like my goal, to play for Middlesbrough, obviously. And I went into the academy when I was 13. And then kind of just like settled in quite quickly, started playing up age groups, and then it came about how I think it normally comes about, but I was quite a late one. And like, I think the most important thing is I had that grounding of, I enjoyed my Sunday league with my friends, got to do my athletics, like very relaxed. And I think that taught me, like I say, I enjoy the competitive side, the battles. I feel like you get that from when you're a kid playing Sunday league. So like, yeah, I wouldn't like have anything to change about, you know, the way I was brought up with football.
And you went on to become Middlesbrough's youngest ever player, which is, you know, fantastic achievement for you. He was 16 years and 75 days, is that right?
Yeah, something like that.
Against Notts County in the Carabao Cup. I mean, how did that feel? That must have been
It was nice.
Dream come true.
It was nice. It was weird how it came about. Like when I was in year 11, I'd come in on day release and I'd train with the first team. Like Tony Pulis was the manager, and Jonathan Woodgate was one of the coaches. And he was a fan of me because he came from the 18s and I'd played up for the 18s. And then he went to the first team and like he brought lads up to train and he always got me involved. And then when I came in full time, I think Danny Ayala was injured. And I went to Germany with them, done quite well. Like nothing special, just like kind of just went along with it. And then got my chance in the cup, and obviously it was amazing. Like, I remember it being weird because, like, didn't feel any pressure. I had nothing to lose. I was just playing for my hometown club. Like, it was obviously really nice and something that, like, one of my proudest moments, probably.
Yeah, and you know, you'd been combining that with school.
Yeah.
So your mates must have been very jealous of the school.
So when I'd be like training for with the first team, then being at school, but like I can't remember it being that much of a big deal. And then I left school, done my GCSEs, and then had my prom, and then made my debut quite quickly after. And it was nice. It was nice, but like it was just one of those things I just took in my stride.
Yeah. And you got quite a few more games under your belt at Middlesbrough.
Yeah.
Also had loan spells with Crewe and Hibernian.
Yeah.
You know, how important were those periods as learning experiences for yourself, Nathan? In terms of obviously the move at Crewe was a pretty successful one.
Yeah.
You know, the one at Hibs probably didn't go as you'd have liked.
Yeah.
Do you feel you learned a lot about yourself, you know, maybe as a person as much as a footballer?
Yeah, 100%. Obviously, I loved my time at Crewe. I think I made like 10 starts in quite a quick time. And I just needed that to be thrown in and be playing games, and I got injured, so I missed a few games at the end of the season. But the Hibs one, like, I think I learned most about myself as a person because it totally pushed me, like, mentally. I was away from home, and I wasn't playing like I wanted to play, and it was tough, but I learned a lot about myself, and I feel like I've come out better from it. Like, I feel like them types of experiences, like, you can't look back with bad blood. You've just got to, like, think, like, everything happens for a reason. And I really do believe in that, like, and it was good for me now. Totally different. My outlook on certain things in life is totally different because of it. Yeah. I feel like, because I always threw myself into my football 100%.
Yeah.
And I feel like when you go somewhere, like, away from home, you need the balance of, like, something to focus on outside football. And that was a big thing for me, learning that. And, like, obviously, when I look back on it, it was tough, but, like, it was like I needed it, and it helped me in the long run.
Yeah, yeah. And you were mentioning earlier, there's a couple of familiar faces you know here. You know Nathaniel.
Yeah.
Ogbetta from your time in the England age group set up, and Jamie Patterson was on trial at Middlesbrough last year. So, you know, that'll be nice for you guys to come into a dressing room and know a couple of the lads.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Well, I know that quite well. We get on well. Like, we're both quite chilled and calm when we're on international duty, but, like, we get on well. Obviously, he's a lovely lad, and I know Pat off from when he came to Middlesbrough, and, like, he's a good lad as well, like, a big character, like, and I'm just looking forward to, like, getting started, really, and, like, meeting new people and just, you know, settling in.
Yeah, and you have leadership experience from that time in England set up. You captained the Three Lions at those levels. Is that something you see as an asset in yourself? Do you feel you are somebody who likes to lead? You like to set the example?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like that adds to my performance, being having that responsibility. Makes me step up, like, in a way. And it is nice. That's obviously something as I get older, I see myself playing that role. And it's good, like, it adds edge to your performance, like helping people around you, keeping you clued into the game, but it's also something you can do, like, when you're fresh into a team. It's not something you have to, like, you know, work your way to. Like I'm sure the best leaders, like your likes of John Terry, people like that, like, I'm sure they were like that from day one. And I feel like that's just in me. I remember in school, like, I'd always get told I was a leader, and I used to be like, I'm not a leader, I'm just like, and like as I got older, I realised that, like, no, this is something that might come natural to me, so I pursue it because it does help my game.
Yeah, and just one last question, just want to ask, what do you hope you can achieve on an individual level at Swansea, and what do you hope you can help the club achieve as a whole while you're here?
Well, obviously for me, I've came here to play and improve, like that's just like standard for me. Everywhere I go, like, you just want to, like, get better. But, like, I feel like Swansea, like, you look at the facilities, like, the people at the club, the players, the fans, the stadium, everything. Like, it's a Premier League club, and I think that's where everyone wants to see Swansea. And it's, I feel like it's a no-brainer. You may as well, like, there's no point setting low goals or whatever. Like, you should aim to be, like, the absolute best. So I think that's just... That comes as a given. You just want to win every game, take every game as it comes, and hopefully that brings success. And if it doesn't, then you improve from it and makes you better. So, yeah.
Well, we wish you every success, Nathan. Once again, welcome to Swansea City.
Thank you. Cheers.